So now I'm going to talk about the two stories about inclusivity. That was my title, which will talk to you what do you do and what kind of amazing impact it can have when you actually open your platform. So I call it the best banana story. Inclusivity is a very tough thing to do. It requires you to open your doors. It requires you to let people in your platform. It requires let people in your code. It requires let people in your data. You have to open it up to everybody, right? So in Indonesia, people love this thing called fried banana. And there was an anomaly in our fried banana. And the anomaly was very simple, that we could not figure out that one location, something is wrong with that one location. So if you look at this map, this actually visualizes our orders across Java Island. And if you look at this map, this actually visualizes our orders across Jakarta as a city. And the one thing which you can spot out of those 150,000 points is a red dot. Humans are very good visual creatures. You can spot anomalies very quickly. If you ask a machine to do this, it might take some time. But if you keep visualizing things, you can draw the patterns, you can figure out things which are much, much easier for you to look and observe and understand that what's happening over there. So we did that, and we found this red dot. And this red dot was a very strange thing. And this is our sender versus receiver anomaly. So what was happening on this red dot, that people were actually couriering things to themselves. And various people were couriering things to themselves. And we figured out what is happening over here. We looked at it. We sent people over there. So we found that there was a small banana shop which was selling fried bananas. And it was not listed on any food platform. So people were actually sending our courier drivers to go and pick up stuff, pick up the fried bananas, and deliver to themselves because that was very tasty. So what we did, we actually included that fried banana shop into our platform. And we listed them on our GoFood platform. So then this is what happened after this.
Pisang goreng madu bunani dimulai dengan sangat tradisional. Dulu cuman jualan di pinggir jalan. Jualan awalnya 10 pieces per hari aja kadang-kadang nggak nyampe. Tapi begitu daftar, saya ingat sekali hari pertama GoFood datang 3 driver Gojek. Sekarang kurang lebih 350-400 driver Gojek per hari. Jadi kalau sebulan tuh kurang lebih ada 350.000-400.000 pieces pisang terjual melalui Gojek setiap bulannya.
Cool. So we actually this was like a year and a half back. So now Pisang Goreng sells around $100,000 of food every day, every month. They sell 1 million of fried bananas every month, and they're our first GoFood millionaires.